An Academy. Let's crack it.
Greetings of the day. I'm Shreyas Datar from Pune, Maharashtra, and I secured an All India rank of 7 in CLAT 2021. The CLAT, or the Common Law Admission Test, serves as the gateway to the national law universities, our country's premier and finest law institutions. In this short video, I'll be sharing some of my preparation tips and strategies for the benefit of future aspirants. I'll be covering briefly about my own college, about my CLAT preparation journey, about general tips and strategies for the CLAT paper, and a brief insight into my journey of becoming a lawyer one day, which is currently still in process, by the way. Let me introduce myself first. I'm currently in my first year of the BA LLB Honours Programme at the National Law School of India University in Bangalore, also known as NLSIU. This university is the dream of every law aspirant, most law aspirants in the country, and it's famous for its academic rigour and its intense research-based method of teaching. However, as an NLS student myself, or as an NLU student, I can assure you, I can assure every future CLAT aspirant that once you make it to your dream law school or dream law university, all the hard work, perseverance, patience, sweat, toil that you have put into your preparation seems worth every ounce of it. So that brings me to my own CLAT preparation journey. I decided that I wanted to pursue law sometime in my 12th grade. To be precise, in September 2020. And from September 2020 to July 2021, I actively prepared for the CLAT. So in my opinion, a preparation time of 1 to 2 years is sufficient for any average aspirant to make it to his or her dream university. Some prepare for 2 years, some prepare for even less than a year. But at the end of the day, what matters is your own hard work, your own commitment, your own dedication, and your own perseverance with being able to prepare for a rigorous exam like CLAT. So as sort of a disclaimer for the entire video, I would like to emphasize on the point that a one-size-fits-all approach cannot work in an exam like CLAT. This is an exam that does not have a vast syllabus. This is an exam that does not test your rote memorization skills. Instead, what this exam asks from you is a test of your critical reasoning abilities, a test of your ability to patiently read a text and understand it, your ability to apply some of the core legal concepts that you would be dealing with as law students and later as lawyers, and your presence of mind. So as a disclaimer, a one-size-fits-all approach cannot work when these particular skills, which are individualized or personalized in nature, are being tested. And therefore, whatever I say should be taken as a general tip or a general direction. Emulating it in letter and spirit might not always be the best option. Now that brings me to some of the core strategies or the core concepts, core fundas that you must keep in mind as you begin or as you continue your CLAT preparation with greater intensity. The first most important tip for any CLAT aspirant is the importance of practice. Practice your mock test regularly. Practice your sectional test regularly. Practice the habit of speed reading regularly. Practice the habit of reading newspapers every day. Keep practicing. Never lose the momentum. At one point of time, you have to get used to being bored with that same routine of mocks, sectional test, solving, analysis, and you have to do it every day for months on end. Yes, it will get boring. Yes, there will be periods of burnout. Yes, there will be periods when you will be questioning why you're doing this. But remember, think about your dream university. Think about wanting to study the law at a place like NLU's. And I think that was something that helped me deal with all the burnouts, with all the periods of questioning that I faced in my CLAT preparation. Practicing at least one mock a day in the last 2-3 months of your CLAT preparation, I think is very important. And that's something I did personally. I solved about 100 to 150 mocks in the last 3-4 months, and that singularly helped me improve my score from a low 50 to about 100 to 110. So yes, practice is my first tip. Second is the importance of reading newspapers every day. And by reading the newspapers, I don't mean read the first page or the editorial or the opinions. By reading the newspapers, I mean read the entire newspaper, except of course the advertisements and the local news. Read the first page, read the page on national news, read the page on international news, read the page on economy, read the page on policy and governance, read all the explainers about the various current affairs, statutes, acts, doctrines, that are there in most mainstream newspapers, and of course read the editorials and the opinions. Yes, you will again feel bored reading the same thing again and again at some point of time, but persevere. There are three important reasons why I recommend the reading of newspapers. First, of course, is that it helps you with your GK section. Second is that reading the newspapers will help you practice speed reading. Because when you're reading the report, when you're reading the editorial, when you're reading the opinion, when you're reading literally anything in the newspaper, you're not just reading it, but you're reading it with speed, and you're also understanding it in the process, which is the art of speed reading. And the third important reason why you should read the newspapers is because, according to my observation, a lot of the passages we got in our final exam were taken directly from the newspapers. They might be about Indian diplomacy, they might be about COVID-19 vaccinations, but a lot of passages in the reading comprehension section and the logical reasoning section were directly from the newspapers. And having cultivated in myself a habit of reading the newspaper every day for about 2 years in my 11th and 12th, I could actually recollect having read those passages in a newspaper a few months ago. And that was a tremendous booster when it came to understanding that passage. I had already read it, and therefore I already knew the concept that was being enunciated, elucidated in the passage. And therefore all I had to do was just read the passage and solve the 5-6 questions based on it. Which brings me to my third important tip. And that is to get a foundational idea about the fundamental or core legal concepts that you'll be encountering in your CLAT exam, in your law school, and in your future practice as a lawyer one day. Now, I do not recommend memorizing the statutes, memorizing the case laws, memorizing the legal doctrines or legal any other form of legal scholarship. That's something you can do in law school or later in your life. At this stage, however, what you must do is get a very foundational overview of what a concept means. By a concept, I mean something like the concept of consent, the concept of res judicata, the concept of contract in law, the concept of constitutionalism, the concept of right to equality or right to life and liberty. All of the knowledge that you require of these basic concepts can be found on the blog pages of any eminent lawyer, advocate, any legal services website, or any legal journal, or even something that can be given by your respective CLAT teachers. However, the reason why I recommend aspirants to get a foundational idea of these legal concepts is because when you're solving the legal aptitude, legal reasoning section, you get a passage in front of you. And when you look at that passage, it is very beneficial for you from the point of view of saving time, that you already know what's being written or what's being argued in the passage. If you know the concept that's being talked about in the passage, it saves a lot of time in trying to understand the concept. If you don't know what's being talked about in the passage, you will have to spend about a minute or two first understanding what's in the passage, then reading it, and then solving. The first step can be skipped if you are already familiar with some of these basic legal concepts. And the fourth important tip, and that's sort of a generalized tip, is to take good care of your mental and physical health. Because CLAT requires rigorous preparation that stretches on for months. As I said, it requires you to get bored with the same routine day after day for 3-4 months. And that is something you cannot do if you're out of shape. Exercise every day. Try to indulge in your hobbies for a while. Do not become a lifeless individual. Because there will be periods of burnout, there will be periods when you question why you're doing all of this. And you cannot let your motivation slip during these crucial moments. You cannot lose the momentum during these crucial moments. And that can only come if you are happy, if you're motivated, and if you're healthy. And then, of course, briefly about my journey so far in becoming a future lawyer. It's been fantastic. In simple words, it's been a fantastic journey. It's been a great learning experience. Just getting this transitioning from being a CLAT aspirant or law aspirant to a law student at a school like NLSIU has been an overwhelming experience. It has been a steep learning curve, as I said. And of course, this is one assurance I can give to all of you guys, is that once you get into a law university of your choice, once you actually step into a law school and begin your journey of becoming a future lawyer, you will feel that every effort you made for CLAT was worth it. And that is why you must give your best for CLAT. And that's my sort of parting message to you all. give your best, be motivated, read about motivation, read about positive things, take good care of your health, practice consistently, do not lose the momentum. All the best to all the future aspirants. Hoping to see you at one of the coveted NLUs.